Welcome to the session. Here we are going to see the conversion of regular expression to NFA with epsilon mu. That is, here we are going to discuss how we can convert the given regular expression into NFA with epsilon mu. So the three basic operations here we have are union, concatenation and closure. So with these three basic operations we are going to convert the regular expression into NFA. And before converting this regular expression to NFA, first we should know the fundamentals that is used to convert a regular expression to NFA with epsilon. So by taking the three basic operations, that is union, concatenation and closure. So whenever there is an union operation between two symbols, okay, then how we can construct the NFA for that? And whenever a concatenation is there between two symbols, then how the NFA will be? And whenever we have a closure, then how that NFA will be? So these are all the fundamentals, and based on this we are going to construct the NFA with epsilon mu for the regular expression. So when we have union operation, then this is how we have to construct the NFA. That is by taking the input symbols R and S here. And here this is the starting node and this is the accepting node. Okay, so this is the starting state and accepting state. And from the starting state, we have a transition to this state. And this state have another transition to this state with the input R. And with this state to an accepting state, and here you can see from starting state to this state and from this state to accepting state, here the transition is happening on epsilon moves. So that is what we are specifying epsilon here, and these for these two transition we have the input symbol R and S. In the same way, if it is concatenation, then this is how we should represent the concatenation. So then there is a transition between these two states and these two states on input symbol R and S, and in between this we have one more transition for epsilon. And coming to closure, so when we say closure here, it represents one or that is zero or more transition. So when this is the case, then we can construct NFA like this. So here you can see from this state to this state we have a transition on input A, whereas these transitions are happening on epsilon. So here there is one transition from this node to this node. This is also happening on the input symbol epsilon. And we can see one more transition happening here from this state to this state, that is also happening on epsilon. So by these fundamentals, with these fundamentals, we can construct the NFA for the given regular expression. So for this expression, how we can construct NFA? Initially, first we are taking this 0 plus 1 alone. Okay, so we can see this is the union operation. So whenever we have union operation on two symbols, then this is how we can construct the NFA and with epsilon moves. And you can see here I have used numbers on this nodes. Okay, so don't bother about the values of nodes now. So these numbers can be given later. At last we can give these numbers, so don't bother about the values on these nodes. First we'll construct the NFA for the union operation. Okay, then after union operation we have closure. Okay, so we need to find the closure for this one. So we are taking this as the basic tree. Okay, sorry, basic graph. Then we'll construct the closure. Okay, so for this we are constructing the closure, right? And then we have concatenation of 1. So after this we have to concatenate the input symbol 1. So for that, from this, okay, from this here we are taking another two states where we have a transition on input symbol 1. Okay, so in between this one and this one we have a transition on epsilon. Finally, after this we have again concatenation of this 0 plus 1. So we can take the previous tree, that is graph itself, that is for 0 plus 1. And with that, okay, we are going to concatenate this 0 plus 1 closure 1 with the 0 plus 1. Okay, so this is the final NFA with epsilon mu that we derived for the regular expression 0 plus 1 closure 1 and 0 plus 1. In the same way, here we are constructing the NFA for this given regular expression. And here we can see the concatenation of 0, 0, 0. So this is how we can represent the NFA for the concatenation 0, 0, 0. And after that we have closure here. So for this we need to add closure. So that is what we have done here. And then after this, 1 is concatenated with this 0, 0, 0 closure. So here we are concatenating 1. Okay, along with this we are concatenating the input symbol 1. So like that we constructed the final NFA for this input. So this is how we can convert the given regular expression into NFA.